Hello and welcome everyone, Lanhart here with Warrior Sparta.
Hello, hello.
Part 19 now.
Yes, it's flying.
Of the Versus
campaign.
This Etruscan League. I would love to attack the Sudbury's, but I don't have any armies up there. Although 1,200 is a lovely payment.
Very
I'm just going to make you reject this by demanding 4,700 instead. There we go.
Thank you. That puts that to bed.
Yeah, that's done. So yeah. We're back.
Yes, this campaign has been... This is what this actual DLC has been out for so many months now. It seems like Hannibal the Gates was released years ago.
Yeah, it's taken ages. I guess it's because the...
Hey, what? Who
the...
Why are we involved in this? Oh, because I'm outside. Yeah, that's because...
Oh, right. I'm gonna play as the AI.
What? Okay.
With my crappy little weak force. Although, actually, yeah, you guys aren't much better.
This is a naval battle again, you know.
Is it a naval battle?
Oh, I just sort of point that in there.
Bloody hell.
You know.
That's all right.
You guys saw the stream, you know.
Oh, God, yeah. It's because, I mean, I found that since in Octavian Let's Play. Like, transport ships now are just... Shit.
Yeah, they are shocking.
They're just so crap, whereas assault ships, by comparison, are brilliant. And it's like, now navies make sense.
Yeah, because I think when they first came out, transport ships were like, badass.
Yeah, and all I've got are bloody transports.
Oh, shit, yeah, they've been nerfed.
Oh, crap's sake. Right, these aren't my troops, I don't care as much. Just throw them at you and just have some fun, I don't know.
Thing is, I'm not controlling any of you at the moment. I'm coming in from the east as reinforcements. I'm going to expect spectators.
Okay, let's see how this goes.
Now, guys, we haven't been together, in terms of this game, I mean, since the announcements of all the revolutions of Total War Tillerison, have we? Obviously, we've had the announcement date.
17th. Oh, of course, yeah, and the pre-order. Bonus!
Yes. Bonus, Viking Forefathers!
Yeah. I think, echo what some others have said, that the pre-order bonus itself isn't necessarily a bad deal.
No.
If you're interested in it. Just recommend maybe actually just holding off.
Yeah.
Don't pre-order yet, because you can pre-order the day before. You know, unless they obviously come out and say, you know, there's a time limit. But normally the way these things work, you can pre-order right until the day before the game is due to come out. So let's just wait for some more information. Hopefully we'll get some soon. I mean, it's coming up to Christmas. I'm sure before CA go on their like Christmas break or something like that, we'll get some more stuff. I think actually saw on Twitter their next rally point they're working on at the moment. They should have some more information. They've just done a new developer blog as well, talking about marriages and agent development and all the stuff that is slowly coming out more and more.
Looks like it's worth it.
Yeah, it's making... I think most of the Total War YouTubers feel a little bit more, a little bit less uneasy about this because, you know, obviously we know what, we're all gamers at the end of the day and we all know what happened with Rome 2, so we don't want a repeat of that.
No, we don't want as much as you don't, you know.
Yeah, and I mean, obviously we all got to go, well, a large group of Total War YouTubers got to go and play Attila at EGX London.
Yeah.
So, you know, we've had a chance to have a look at it. Obviously, the public has as well. So, you know, we're a bit wary of it because this is kind of the same sort of stuff we saw with Rome 2. Looked great. Development was coming along well. And then, obviously, the launch didn't stand up to that. So I think a lot of us are all taking things a lot more cautiously this time. I know I am. Because, you know, I got to do a fair few previews for Rome 2's launch. And the preview stuff I looked at, you know, it wasn't the same that the launch was. You know, it was quite different, so...
It was. And, you know, I mean, we played the build at EGX, and it did play well, and I was, you know, satisfactorily impressed with it. It's just, as you say, I mean, how good... I mean, what someone said to me, how powerful was the PC that I was playing it on. I mean, I don't think it would have been the top spec PC, would it, that CA had put towards that that build? I don't really know.
No, I think they were... I think actually most of them were using AMD cards there.
Yeah.
They weren't, like, the best in the world. So, you know, I mean, they're going for the whole thing that basically, if you can run Rome 2, you can run Attila.
Exactly.
That's a definite, you know. Oh god, these ships are getting wrecked.
I know, yeah.
I'm trying to get them to use their missiles, but it's just not working.
Where's your line, Hall? It's just you and water.
It's god. I'm trying to ram you because these are transport ships that they're coming in.
I'm having a blast on this right side.
You've got proper ships.
Yeah. I could say something else then, but okay, ships. Yeah.
Proper shit.
Yeah.
At your command. Oh, that was a whack and a half.
Oh, that was. I'm just wavering as well. They've wavered. Great. Carry on.
But, so... things we're seeing from Attila, they do look good. They do look awesome.
Yeah, it's the in-depth they've got into.
I am getting excited for Attila. Vikings sound awesome. Dark Ages sound awesome.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, we discussed it beforehand. The fact that what they're adding to the game is that CK element, that Crusader Kings real grand strategy element they're trying to go for.
They're starting to add in some stuff, which, you know, maybe in the next couple of Total Wars could develop into something pretty special in terms of adding depth. And they've certainly listened to the community when people said, we want family trees in, we want...
the enemy general is dead. Oh,
Cotto. I'm just saying to their deaths right now. I don't care. Don't care.
My trick word. I've got you to talk about Attila to put you off.
Exactly. My brain's like, what do I do?
Yeah.
Trickster.
Lol. Even that massive transport ship you've got against my little.
Yeah, it's going to do nothing.
Raiding ship has not done a thing. Go again.
It's just like my ships at this point. Just give up on life. Just suicide or something.
Oh my
right
god!
Now. What? That's it. That's Must it. It's panic. All routing. Screw it. Anyway, back to Vikings and Attila.
Yeah.
So, if you're cautious, if you think it's underhanded that they're doing day one DLC that's coming out, yes, it may well be. And to be honest, I'd have preferred for them to wait a little bit more. This is basically pre-order. Boosts and pre-orders, which I think by and large you can probably say thanks Sega for that one.
We saw it in Rome 2.
Yeah.
Greek states.
Publishers are generally the ones that look at DLC and if you know what the
No, it's not me. This is the enemy again.
I
just saw it. Ultra Resolve. 100%. Yeah.
Yeah, largely publishers are the ones that kind of look at which content gets turned into DLC or whether it's commissioned content that's extra or as some people they feel it's content that's cut out of the base game. End of the day, CA aren't the only developers that have games that feature this stuff.
And it will never stop. Well,
you can take a stand and vote with your wallet in terms of make a finished game. I wouldn't say you can really make an effective stand in the games industry as it is now against, say, day one DLC.
No.
Oh, enemy forces, rebels. Okay, I'm going to fight this one. But because it's such a broad, commonplace thing. I know there's some developers and some publishers that don't do it, and that's great. But unfortunately, DLC and day one DLC is probably here to stay.
It's the way, as you say, developers, publishers are going. And if CA are not silly, they can see that obviously this is profitable, and they will try and boost that because they're there to do that.
Yeah.
And you know, these companies want to try and enhance their product, and I think it's not terrible.
Yeah. So, I mean, basically at the end of the day, if you're not sure about pre-ordering, if you don't like the day one DLC, or if you do like the day one DLC and you really want to go out and pre-order straight away, all of you, everyone, whether you're planning on pre-ordering or not. Wait another month or two. Let's wait until, you know, start of the new year. Wait till January. Then put your pre-order in. The prices shouldn't change at all.
Exactly. And
you should still be able to get a good pre-order from various different places. You can get it on Steam. You can pre-order as well. That's not going to change. It's £29.99 British pounds. So, you know, that's not going to change in between now and its release. If it does, then I'd be incredibly surprised, but normally that sort of thing doesn't change. There's nothing. If Rome 2 had a great launch, to be honest, we'd probably just be a bit like, oh yeah, well they did this with the Greek states, it's how it rolls now. But Rome 2 had a bad launch, so we're a bit more cautious this time around. So I think with that, air some caution now. don't pre-order or anything just yet. Just wait to see how the game develops, what new information we find out about, what more features get announced, what if there's any other DLC or factions planned that we hear about before release. Wait until that's all out in the open. And then, as I said, you know, like middle of January or even, you know, start of February, then throw your pre-order in.
You haven't got that long to wait.
No.
And
it's going to be out sooner than we all think.
Yeah. And there's one little thing we haven't mentioned yet, and that was on the special edition preview shot. There's a little tiny card that says Huns, and we don't know yet about them, if they're going to be playable or not, because a lot of speculation going around there, because we thought they weren't. And have you seen that little screenshot of it?
Yeah, I have. As far as I understand, the Huns are an emergent faction in the game, so
yeah,
you know, they will appear like the emergent factions we're actually quite used to seeing in previous Total Wars, which is a good thing. I quite like the fact that emergent factions are back. I think that's good, because it kind of potentially insinuates that there might be some events like there used to be in some of the other Total Wars, historical events that will happen.
Missed that.
And, you know, they'll link in, that'll be fun as well. So I'm hoping they make a return.
It's just the way that card, I mean, a lot of people are saying that they think, well, they could be a playable faction, but then I'm thinking, well, and I've heard they are the boss level.
I'd almost love for them to be, if you beat them in the game, then you unlock them to play as a later game start pos.
Nice.
So you'll be able to start the game as the Huns later on or something like that. Like you've got in Empire Total War, you've got late and early start positions for all the factions there. I'd love it to be that, but at the same time, I also doubt that that's what we'll get. To be honest, the thing is, it's weird because in one way, I don't believe that CA would almost release a DLC campaign like, say, Hannibal at the Gates, where you can finally play as the Huns when the game is called Attila.
Yeah, exactly. It's not gonna work, that, is it?
I don't know. I mean, it seems like you can't play as them. But
well, yeah.
I reckon if you can't play as them in the game, there probably will be some sort of campaign DLC. All I could hope is that they'll do a free DLC campaign update like they did with Imperator Augustus. Mm. And that, you know, later on, you'll be able to play it as the Huns for free. It won't cost you any more if you've already got the game.
Well, it's like Napoleon Total War. You could always play as a French and you always could play as Napoleon.
Yeah, it does seem a bit odd.
You know.
That there's no point in it. I mean, maybe they're keeping tight-lipped about it because it's a special, cool way of introducing it or something like that. But
big announcement or something, yeah.
I don't know.
We'll find out.
Yeah, you've got me confused on this one, but
that takes a lot. That does take a lot with you.
I generally don't know what they're going for. Like, I don't know what to guess with this one. I mean, you guys can see how kind of confused we are about the whole thing. So, again, that just reiterates the point. Wait a little bit longer, see what more information we find out, and let's go from there, kind of together as a community. Let's
support
wait.
It. Yeah.
Yeah. But if you were, you know, so sourly turned off by Rome 2, the whole, you know, launch, stuff like that, then wait for us Muppets to, you know, get the game and make some Let's Plays about it if you want to see how it actually plays.
I mean, so far, I quite agree with you. Hold off to a little bit, see what happens. But so far, it's been promising. It has been promising. I really have thought that they're going in the right direction. They've listened to us, all the community, and it looks promising.
Yeah, it does. It does seem all right so far.
Yes, right. Been talking about God. I started that conversation off about 2 years ago. And
we've God.
Right.
Oh dear. My squares are being targeted. Oh no.
Is there a rebellion uprising in the... Whereabouts is this actually? Is it rebellion?
Oh god, this Italian... Oh, I forgot about the bloody Italian cavalry.
Oh wait, I had him hiding in the woods, you see. So.
Ew, douche. Son of a gun.
Rusty cavalry. Oh, you got plebs. Oh god, I didn't realize they're just plebs. I don't want them breaking off from them. Oh, hello. Of
Our general is under attack.
Plebs, turn around. Kill the noble infantry. No, plebs, no.
Go, nobles. It's your birthday. Come on. Pull back out of there. Okay, we're doing over this side. We've got some wavering from the Royoi. I can never say that word. It's a tongue twister for me. Most of the names in this game are. Every single episode I'm picked up for my pronunciation of something.
Oh, same.
Terrible. Yeah. It's just terrible. Oh, hello. Don't want to get involved with them. Okay, push out over there. Plebs can be taken down surely by the Italian swordsman. And congratulations to you, my friend, for reaching the Silver Shield final.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, I'm about to die from Prussian Prince.
Yeah. It's going to be tricky.
He will wreck me.
It's going to be tricky.
Yes, it's not going to go amazingly. I can...
Have faith, my friend. Have faith in your abilities. Come on. You must believe.
It was a mass click spam.
Yeah.
The previous ones.
I did enjoy yours and Rambler's one. That was quite effective. I used the Throwback Swordsman in the end.
Yes.
Just obliterate his left flank. Or the right flank.
Can't do here. You've got too many units against me.
Yeah, there's quite a substantial rebellion this is, actually.
Come on.
What have you done to him to make him so peed off?
Oh, I think I don't know, probably killed too many of their cavalry friends. Maybe that's they're all their family friends that you've sunk on the the last part.
Yeah, they've risen up. They've had enough. This is it. This is payback. Okay. Cavalry just enjoying the view at the moment. They really don't want to get involved with your Royori. Hang on, your general's come across. Oh, hello. I didn't realise. Oh, cleverly done. I like that. Because what you've done is you've boxed in with cavalry. And, of course, I can't get round to support my...
Yep.
Universe telling your swordsman. Ah, it's more to you than meets the eye, Mr. Lionheart.
Only a little bit more.
Only a little bit more. Hang on, I'm pulling back. I can't get through at all. There's no way I'm going to get through there. Need to break through this side here. Get the Astarte to fall. Oh! Balls. We could have some problems now all of a sudden. Oh dear.
Hoping so.
Oh dear. You discipline units, for God's sake. Your silver chevrons. Hold, come on.
Balls, I'm out of ammo.
Don't know how your levies did then. You had a bit of a sing and dance, and then they all started charging in. Good live stream last time. I forgot we didn't live stream. We live streamed the last time, didn't we? Which
yeah.
Was pretty epic stuff. Men are wavering. Don't tell me that. Oh, go away! Keep reacting to my bloody cavalry. Go on, go back. Oh, hang on. Now's the time to pop through. Go to that gap. Oh! I thought you were going to get me then. Right, here we go for a charge. Come on, hit that general from behind.
It's alright, I'm in square.
Oh, balls. Oh, no, don't say that. Italian cavalry, charge! Okay.
Okay, going down fighting.
Yeah, going down like a true Roman today. Okay. Go. Even the levy skirmishers have finished off their ammunition, so they're going for a charge. Come on, this is it. Get that general down. Got a form square, I can see. Nice.
Ah. Yeah, no, you've got me there, I think.
Not over to the fat lady sings. Gemma. Oh! Whoa! She's upstairs having a bath, thank God.
Oh, that's all good, otherwise we're dead.
Yeah, me dead, man. Me sleeping on the couch, man.
outside.
Yeah, you're not going down without a good fight here, my friend. I tell you, because
you've... Oh, one of them's on fire. Oh, there we go.
Oh dear.
How do you get on fire?
I think the ships are firing, aren't they? From the they've got the artillery on the yeah. There's a
oh, it's my tower.
Tower,
yeah.
Yeah, little tower. Yeah.
Just killed one of my men though. Great. Italian cavalry. Well, my general unit is gone.
Come on. God, you are holding on for dear life here.
That's
good.
It. Stick the cavalry. Oh, nice. Knocked him off the horse. Love it. Oh, two of them off.
I just want to try and break your Riarii. Come on, Jesus.
Come on. Hold, men, hold.
That's the most ineffective charge I've ever seen in my life. Just sort of gradually trotted towards him. Oh, the general's starting to drop now. He's shaken. Here we go.
Oh, general's still there.
Oh, what a performance.
Oh, they're still holding in that square.
It is pretty impressive.
I thought they'd gone. Oh, no, they've
and that's
broken
it.
Out.
That's it. GG.
Played.
Well played, yeah.
But I will have my vengeance.
In this life. Well, you probably are, yeah. This is all nice and nicey nice, but there's all these problems down in Carthage that's still happening. Right. Right, is that... Oh, is it just finished? Oh, my map is now all over the place. So are they taking that settlement now from you, or is it just...
I think so, yeah. The rebels will claim it. Yeah, taking Little Bem. Not so good.
No. Right. Okay, so it's over to moi. I am a reaper of souls. Okay, so quick chat. My skills have swayed many men. Come on.
You trying to take out my spy? I saw that. Oh, you've stopped her from acting or moving. Damn you.
Damn it. Damn you, man. The thing is, you're still bloody raiding. What have you got there? Okay. What have we got? Where's the champion? Champion's there. Spy's all the way over there.
Let's see what you can muster. I can't afford to strike you. Carthage is too strong with its garrison. With you with two armies around it. Can't do too much yet.
Like the fortress of Dolgodor. What the hell is this? Why have I got a judge over at Katuruba? The hell's he and what's he over there for? Did you enjoy that Hobbit trailer I liked and then you liked it?
I did, yeah. The legacy one.
What a combination.
So good.
Epicness, isn't it? Yeah, it was very good indeed. Yeah. Oh, Christ! I didn't know you got two armies there.
Hello, pop it. Oh, and who's in force march?
But why can't I go back?
Because you're in my area now.
Oh, shh.
The word you're looking for is shit.
God, that is awful. That is awful.
That's a solid army you have there, though. Not one to be broken lightly.
Oh, Christ. How can I serve? Well. I can't risk losing that army in a forced march dance. Oh, God. Wow.
The battle will decide it.
How long have we been recording?
About 25 minutes. I think we should be...
This is it. This is the ultimate cliffhanger.
Yeah. We're gonna be arseholes, guys, and wrap up the part there. But we will get together again soon.
Oh, that was awful. I can't believe I did that. Ah! But thank look you. At this.
The auto resolve. If I were to auto resolve this, this is looking good in my favor, but I'm going to have to quickly save it. Oh, no, I can't save it. Can you save it?
I can quick save it, yes.
There we go. Yeah, quick save. Right, we'll quickly wrap up then. So, we hope you enjoyed this part. Don't forget to comment, rate, subscribe. Check out both channels. Links are in the description. And we will see you next time.
Bye.
Ciao for now.